Next, we've got a box, a flat piece of cardboard that they're going to fold into a box. They say that it is a square sheet. Y'all, if this is a square, which it may be, but it's like an optical illusion because it does not look like a square at all. But they say it's a square that has a length of 40 inches. So before they cut anything off of it, so from here all the way here is supposed to be 40 inches, which means that this from here to here is 20, so this would be 20, and then be 40, if you're looking at like 0 to 20, 20 to 40, it's like cut in half, and I don't know about y'all, but it really seems like an optical illusion. But the sheet is cut and pieces are discarded, so these corners have been cut off, and then it's folded up into a box. So we're looking for the... So if you read it, you have to keep reading, but it basically says we're trying to either minimize or maximize volume and find the place where that occurs. So volume of a box is length times width times height, which in this case, let's say this is the length of my box. It's going to be this long box right here. This is actually the length of my box, right? That is 40 minus 2x. That's how we came up with that portion of the box. If this represents the width of my box, that's from here, right? So the width of my box is going to be 20 minus x. And then the height of your box is like the part that the little piece is folded up, so it's just this. So it's just x. So I want to power rule this. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply this all out, distribute and everything. So if I distribute 800 minus 40x minus 40x, so that's minus 80x plus 2x squared, and I'm going to distribute a 2 through that. At the same time, y'all, just because it makes me feel better and because I know we're going to have to factor this in it, I'm going to flip it all around. So I am going to distribute my x3, but I'm going to put the 2x cubed at the front, and then minus 80x squared, and then that would be plus 800x. This is now my volume. Now, in order to maximize, I have to take the derivative of that. So taking the derivative of this, I get the derivative of the volume in terms of x is 6x squared minus 160x plus 800. I need to find some critical values. So I'm going to factor this before I do anything. I think I can divide it all by 2. So that would give me 3x squared minus 80x plus 400. So now I'm factoring. So I multiply 3 times 400, and I get 1,200. Looking for factors of 1,200, it would equal 60. So that would be negative 60 and negative 20. And then grouping, that would be a 3x, which would leave me x minus 20, and a negative 20, which would leave me x minus 20. So 3x minus 20 and x minus 20 are my two factors, which means that my two critical points are x equals 20 over 3 and x equals 20. So I have all of this. Now I just have to determine what's a max and what's a min. So remember, we're going to put these on a number line and do a number line analysis. So by the way, this I think was the hardest question on the test, or at least it's on the test. So 20/3, that's like 18-ish, or 3 goes into 20. 6 times 6 and 2/3. So I'm going to put that over here. And here's 20. And I know it can't be any smaller than 0 because I wouldn't have a box. It can't be any bigger than 40 because my box is only 40 inches long. between 0 and 6.8, so I'm just going to use 5. I'm going to plug it in to the factored derivative, which is this. It had a positive 2, but that really doesn't matter. All I'm concerned about is the signs. So if I plug a 5 right here, that would be 15 minus 20, which makes this negative and that negative, and a negative and a negative is a positive. So I'm going to go between 6 and 20, so let's just use 10. That would be 30 minus 20, which is a positive, and 10 minus 20 is negative, so that's positive and a negative, it's a negative. Then I'm going to go between 20 and 40, so let's do 30. 3 times 30 is 90 minus 20, so that'd be positive, and 30 minus 20 is positive, so that's positive. Positive, which means this is a positive, then negative, then positive. So at 20 over 3, I have a max, and at 20, I have a min. So 20 is a minimum, so that cancels out b. 20 over 30 is a max, so that cancels out c. So I'm down to either A or D. So now what you have to do is you're going to have to use extreme value theorem to determine if what you plug in makes it they has the maximum possible value of volume or not, or the minimum possible value. Well, obviously 0 is going to give me 0, so that's like really small. So I don't have to, and it's obviously not a max. So really I'm just going to have to plug in 20 over 30, 20, and 40. So we're going to plug it into the original, not into the derivative, but into the original function. You can plug it in before it's multiplied out because that usually makes it a little bit easier. I am going to do this on a separate piece of paper just because this has got my page has gotten a little bit crowded. So let me grab another piece of paper and do it on that. So I'm plugging into this equation, and I'm going to plug in 20 first. Well, that was easy because if I do 40 minus 2 times 20, that's 40 minus 40, which makes this 0. And that makes this entire piece 0, which means that it doesn't have a volume. So it can't be the 21 to 20 inches. It has to be